Hi, Karen Rao Carter here. It's time for Feng Shui Stories, where hopefully you can learn some Feng Shui tips from the stories that I have from my consultations with my clients. Today I wanted to talk about how to divide up your square footage. You know, we all only have so many square feet in our home, in our business, in our office, in our bedroom, whatever. And we really have to make the most of it. I had one client where she had two out of her three-bedroom house dedicated, two rooms dedicated to her cats. But she didn't have a place for her office, and she was, you know, worrying about how to make money, et cetera, et cetera. And I've had other people where they were really living in two or three rooms in the whole big house, but the rest of the house was, you know, that perfect living room. I call it the fake living room that nobody ever goes into, and the fake dining room that gets used once a year. And I'm really inviting you to not succumb to the designer, whoever it was, the architect, the builder, you know, decided we needed a fake living room. So there's that little fake living room that we open it up once a week and dust it and close the doors, and you know, that's that. Take a moment to customize your square footage. As a landscape architect, you know, there's this thing called the program or the design process. And the first phase of that process is the programming phase. And that's where you figure out what needs to go on here. So, you know, and this is a thing that might change over time. You know, empty nesters, take note, right? All the kids' bedrooms now become like storage toss rooms, and they end up just being clutter filled because you're like, oh, I'll deal with it later. And it just, you know, clutter starts to stick together. And the next thing you know, you've got a big old room full of clutter, right? Used to be a bedroom. You used to have plenty of, you know, life circumstance when that was your child's room, that it wasn't like you needed it for storage. So we need to figure out, what do you really need to do to have to function in life? I would invite you to not only think about the things that you are doing now that maybe, you know, of course I'd like it to be the things you want to do, but you know, there's a place for like ironing and hobbying and things like that. Place to store your arts and crafts or your sporting equipment, or your, you know, collections, if you have them and need them. Nothing's good or bad. If you got the room, you know, it's nothing about me. So if that really gives you joy and it's something that you see yourself in the future always being that collector, that's your collector. You know, like, let's make sure you have the space for it. Get rid of the stuff that's not supporting your dream future. So think big, stretch your dreams a little bit here. Now that you're literally thinking about, okay, how are we going to divide up the square footage? How many kids, how many turtles, how many dogs, how many cats, how many people, how many in-laws, you know, whatever. We need to figure out who this home needs to accommodate, and then what functions this home needs to accommodate. And then we can start figuring out which functions go together. Maybe there's like three that can share one same room because they're similar. We don't want really incongruent functions where the treadmill's next to the bed, something like that. But maybe all the active equipment can be in one room and all the quieter stuff can be in another room if we have to share spaces, share rooms. So now we're going to start thinking about your list, and now think of your dream ultimate list. Maybe you've never been able to do it before, but start to carve a little square footage in your house for that dream item. I had one client who became an avid kayaker. I'll tell her story in another video. But suddenly she needed like space in her garage for her bucket of oars and her tandem kayak and her regular kayak and her a garment rack with wetsuits hanging on it. So, you know, she didn't have that need before, but then she had this dream of being a kayaker and getting in better shape fitness-wise through kayaking. So suddenly there's a square footage need. So we don't want to jam that into some other place that it doesn't make sense, okay? So we're going to rethink the whole house. Maybe whole people's bedrooms are going to move. You know, maybe your master bedrooms turns into the let's do everything in their room, and then you take a smaller bedroom as our bedroom. Feel free. It's your house. Make it custom to you. Okay? And then once you get that you know, list of functions, how many square feet you think it's going to take, which square feet bunches go together, assign the rooms and spaces to where it makes sense. Then you can start figuring out the furnishings, the color choices, and then possibly after that, you know, apply the little Bagua thought pattern to it, add your elements, add your symbols, colors, and things as needed. And that would be a really good way of rethinking, shaking up the house and rethinking it so that, you know, after some, you know, kids moved in, parents moved in, kids went off to college and moved out, boomerang kids, you know, we really have to rethink it and not have these sort of makeshift scoot over, let's put a cot there, whatever, you know, like rethink the whole program so that everything feels like it has a place, everything feels comfortable, and it doesn't feel makeshift or temporary in life. All right, so not that big of a story of the cat lady, but I just really wanted to get the point across of, you know, are you not being able to do something in life because you really haven't set your environment up for it? Claim that space, and what if you build it, it will come, right? So build that field so you can enjoy that hobby or dream future for you. That's your feng shui story for the day. For for more tips, I guess, you can go to moveitwithkaren.com and subscribe there, and you'll get on my newsletter list for more tips, and you'll get a free webinar, and you'll have get access to my website from there, and you'll see all the other things I do. I have a certification course. If you're interested in doing that, feel free to jump in. Turn professional, do this. You know, people in the design world, this makes perfect sense to adjoin feng shui to your interior design, landscape architecture, industrial design, like whatever. Think about incorporating feng shui into the design world. Highly invite you to do that. So more information is on my website. Look at the links below. I'd love to hear your comments about how you rethought your space. Maybe if you can add some pictures or whatever, feel free to do that. And join in with our success stories down below. All right, thanks. Take care. Enjoy. Bye.